So the Interactive Robotics and Vision Lab works in problems in robotics, specifically focusing on outdoor robotics and field robotics, where robots and humans have to work alongside and work safely. And we look at problems that associate with water quality assessment, invasive species, infrastructure inspection, and also marine life inspection. The IRV lab is located in the recently renovated Shepherd Laboratories, and this robotic research space that has been created is called the Gemini Huntley Robotics Research Facility. And because of the nature of this work, we have to put equipment in the water. We use the university recreation centers and the swimming pools almost on a monthly basis. Beyond that, especially when the weather's good and we have the opportunity to travel, we take our robots to the lakes of Minnesota. Last summer, we went to Lake Nokomis, and we had a whole day of field trials conducted there. And as part of a greater international community of marine roboticists, we go to a marine robotics field trial that happens annually in the island of Barbados in the Caribbean. So we currently have four underwater robots. There's three types of robots, but we have four of them. And the primary robot that we use is an autonomous underwater vehicle called Minibot. So Minibot comes from a family of robots called Aqua, and these robots are actually not just swimming robots, these are amphibious robots, so they're capable of walking as well as swimming. And we also have three other ROVs, which are called remotely operated vehicles, and these robots are all used for either algorithm testing or algorithm verification, and also collecting data on which we actually build our algorithms. Our lab is producing students who are quite capable of handling the challenges of the 21st century, specifically with this information-driven and intelligence-driven economy that we see everywhere. Our students, in spite of us being a very young lab, have already been hired by cutting-edge industry like 3M and Walmart. And these industries are also looking at internship positions to be filled, and our students have been getting offers to be an intern in those places. I would like to see these robots being used in the waters without active human supervision, without active human guidance, but then making our lives easier by ensuring the water stays clean, ensuring that the plastic and the trash and the garbage that gets deposited never really gets deposited, and thereby making the environment better and cleaner for future generations to come.